Pilgrimage. We are here at the place where Prince Siddhartha Gautama attained enlightenment on the full moon day on the month of Vesak, sitting under meditating under this Bodhi tree. After attaining enlightenment, he then became known as Gautama the Buddha and sat here meditating without moving for another 7 days. During the Buddha's time, this place was known as Yuravela. Now it is Buddhagaya or Buddhagaya, and millions of Buddhists from around the world come here each year. So we start our journey here, which is fast becoming one of the greatest religious pilgrim centers in the world.
Buddham saranam gacchami, dhammam saranam gacchami.
While Prince Siddhartha was meditating under this tree, he was disturbed by Mara, the demon of evil, who used all sorts of trickery, including sending beautiful scented women to break his concentration. But after several weeks, he overcame these distractions to gain the inner wisdom necessary to attain enlightenment. Thus, he became Gautama the Buddha 589 years before the birth of Christ, here at Buddhagaya. For having given shelter to the Buddha to gain enlightenment, this tree known as the Bodhi tree is venerated around the world by Buddhists. The tree you see here is not the original one, but an offshoot of it because it has been cut several times by those opposed to the Buddha's teachings. Today, this Bodhi tree is so venerated that the Japanese government has sent expert botanists to treat it for possible decay, and they have applied a white powder to improve its health. Many Buddhists believe that by worshipping here, it gives them good karma. So, people of different cultural backgrounds have their own ways of paying homage to the Buddha.
Buddham saranam gacchami, dhammam saranam gacchami, sangham saranam gacchami.
After his enlightenment, the Buddha is believed to have spent a whole week on top of this hill, gazing in meditation at the Bodhi tree in front of him, as a mark of respect to the tree which helped him to attain enlightenment. During the fourth week after his enlightenment, there had been a severe storm, and it is said that the Buddha was protected by a cobra, as shown in this statue, erected in the middle of the pond near the Bodhi tree. This unique architectural masterpiece is known as the Mahabodhi Temple, which was originally erected by Emperor Asoka in the 2nd century AD to mark the place of the Buddha's enlightenment. Some scholars, however, say this particular building was erected in the 5th century, replacing a stupa or a vihara built by Asoka 3 centuries earlier. It is not only Buddhists who come here to worship. For thousands of Hindus, like this group, Buddha Gaya is a place of worship.
The Hindus, they also believe that Buddha was the 10th incarnation of Lord Vishnu. This is for the Buddhist also important. This is for Hindus also it is important. It was into the hands of Hindu for a long, long time also. When the Buddhists, they left in this place. In 12th century AD after Muslim invasion. So after that, this temple was maintained by the Hindu Mahanta. Yeah? This Mahabodhi Mahavihara is run by a committee constituted by the government of Bihar. And this committee has 8 members. And the district magistrate is the chairman, ex officio. And among these 8 members, there are 4 members are Hindu. And 4 members are from Buddhism.
With thousands or millions of pilgrims visiting Buddha Gaya each year, it is no surprise that there is a thriving street market here. It is a common Buddhist as well as Hindu belief that giving money, food or goods to the poor brings you good karma. So this place usually has a large population of beggars living on the generosity of the pilgrims. Surrounding the Mahabodhi Temple are a number of monasteries built by Buddhists from around the world, which reflect the globalized Buddhist culture. Origins, this giant Buddha statue has been erected by a Japanese Buddhist sect. This is the Niranjana River, now known as the Lilijan River. Buddha used to take baths in this river. One day, the Buddha threw his begging bowl into the stream and said that if he is to attain enlightenment, the begging bowl will go upstream. It did, and so Buddha knew that one day he would become the Buddha, the enlightened one. Across this river is Sujata Naga, just 2 kilometers from the Mahabodhi Temple. It is a must-see site for Buddhist pilgrims today. Oh. When the Buddha was meditating under the Bodhi tree for many weeks, he had become very weak. It was at this time that a local girl, Sujata, offered milk rice to him. This stupa has been erected during the reign of Emperor Asoka to mark the place where the offering was given. In many Indian villages, they mix cow dung with straw, and after drying it in the sun, they use these as fuel wood for cooking. Thousands of Buddhist pilgrims visit Buddha Gaya each year, but most of them come from overseas because Buddhism in its birthplace has declined many centuries ago. However, lately, Buddhism is undergoing a marked revival here.
In India, Buddhists were before also, but in our hilly areas in Kashmir, Ladakh, and you know, Sikkim, and in Darjeeling area, you know, or the Himalayan ranges, you know, these Buddhists were all the time there. But now, after Ambedkar's, you know, conversion into Buddhism, so now these Hindus are also getting converted into Buddhism. Now these Buddhist forces, you know, those they call themselves Ambedkarites, they are slowly their numbers increasing in India. At this place, at Buddha Gaya, local people got, you know, conversions into Buddhism. It started in 1972 when young people, you know, literate boys, you know, for the first time they embraced Buddhism with the help of Sri Lankan Bhantes. They came into contact with the Venerable B. Panyarama, who was the in charge of the Mahabodhi Society of India. And so these young boys, you know, literate boys of this place, they came into contact with Buddhism from there. And after that it started, you know, there is a whole village which is called Miyabigha or Siddhartha Nagar, just behind the Mahabodhi temple or Chinese temple. There the whole village converted into Buddhism with the help of these young boys and the Mahabodhi Society of India.
This is Siddhartha Naga on a cold winter morning. This aged monk is heading to the Mahabodhi temple for his morning meditation.
This 10:30 me coming.